On today's episode, I'm going to be talking about setting the standard for your life. And I don't just mean in the nutrition and training sense, but I mean life in general. I know you're thinking, what do you know about life advice? Well, guys, I'm here. I'm going to give it a red hot go and tell you some of the tips and tricks that I really use to transform my life to where it is today. So stay tuned. Chat to you soon. Welcome to the Breakthrough the Bullshit podcast. I am your host, Alice Round. I am pumped to have you here. We are going to really strip back all of the bullshit surrounding nutrition, training, fad diets, everything in the industry so that we can give you education to get the best possible results. So sit back, enjoy the ride, and let's go through all this bullshit. Lovely, lovely ladies and gentlemen. Welcome back to another episode. I know it's been a hot minute, and I'm not apologizing for that because I've been one busy lady, but at the same time I need to raise my standards myself in certain aspects of my life, and one of those aspects I'm going to be focusing on is getting this podcast out and about, being more active on it. Been super active on my Facebook lives, but need to switch back to the podcast because it is more convenient for some of you to listen to podcasts, download them, all those things. If you're listening now on SoundCloud, I thought this would be an easier source of getting the podcast to you. Still hasn't been approved on iTunes, but we'll get there. So at the moment, you can listen on SoundCloud, and I'm going to have it enabled to download as well. So chatting to you guys today about a couple of things, not as fitness and nutrition and training related as what we normally do, but it's something that I really, really have become more and more passionate about talking about. And what that is basically kind of where people are at in their lives. And I've learned so, so much about myself and my own journey from where my clients are. I really, really am grateful for my clients, and not just my clients, but all of the absolute legends that take, you know, 2 minutes out of their day, a minute out of their day, to send me an email, to send me an inquiry, not the ask calls, and I sent an email about that the other day, not the people that just constantly email me asking me a million questions and, you know, wanting free advice 24/7, but they're not actually doing anything about it, but the people that genuinely email me and tell me their stories and ask for help, and you can see that they genuinely, genuinely need help and are reaching out, and this email might have been hard for them to send. I truly appreciate anyone who takes 5 minutes, 2 minutes, 1 minute out of their day to do that, because I get blown away by the emails I get from people telling me their stories. And not even that, but the comments on Facebook. I just ran a challenge last week, and it was a breakthrough binge eating challenge, and it was amazing. Like, the women that I got to connect with in there was 2,000 women in the group, and they were doing this free challenge. And for me, the reason that I was doing it, we don't do a lot of selfless things in life. And I know that sounds horrible, but it's absolutely true. There's always a reason as to why we do things. And the reason for me doing that challenge was I wanted to see how many women were going through the same struggles, what the main struggles were. So day one, I asked the women, she was before day one, I said, why are you here? What is the number one thing you would love to overcome or you'd be able to improve on when it comes to binge eating or when it comes to your relationship with food? And the top comments were things like, I want to gain control back. I want to have confidence in my food choices. And I was like, they are like a goal for being here, but they're not the real nitty gritty of it. Like, what is the end goal? And when we really got down to it, it was like, I want to get my body confidence back. I want to love myself again because I feel like a failure. I want to feel sexy again to my partner because I have this inability to stop my binge eating. I want to feel like I'm an adult, not a child, not letting food control my life. Like, there were so many deeper rooted issues. It was, I'm lonely, so I eat. I'm depressed, so I eat. It was all of these reasons. And that's what I wanted to find out. I wanted to find out why it's women more so than men. And I know that's a generalization, but it is actually true, that have problems with binge eating and mindless eating. And so the reason that I did this challenge was to learn from people. I really, really wanted to learn what they were struggling with so that I could put out the right content to help them. So anyway, over the 7 days, I put out 2 videos every day. One was a live video where I'd go in and chat to them about the stuff that we spoke about the day before, the things I was struggling with. And then the second one would be an action step on what they can actually do to help that. And it was amazing seeing the responses that we were getting. And not just that, but me learning from these women, learning from their stories, learning from their struggles. and learning how, as a coach, I can be better, how I can do better, how I need to set the standard of my life as a coach to be better, to go above and beyond to help women like this, because there's just too much of it going around. There is too many women struggling with binge eating, too many women struggling with being scared of food, too many women scared of carbs, scared of this, scared of that, needing to go on every single diet under the sun, but then never actually get a result. And I'm just fucking over it, to be honest. I'm over people getting taken for a ride, wasting their money on gimmicks, fads, all of this, seeing your life as a diet, then a not diet, diet, then a not diet. When we just need to focus on changing our lifestyle, making changes and focusing more on the way that I see dieting, so to speak, is focusing on periods in your life of being strict and maybe not so strict. So periods of tracking where maybe I'm being a little bit more strict, I've got a holiday coming up, whatever it is, and then a period in your life where you're more relaxed, you're more intuitive, and you learn how to do so that you can do that without gaining excessive amounts of weight. It's not like going on some extreme diet and then going back to the exact same eating regime you're on before and piling on the pounds. In that non-strict tracking phase or intuitive phase, whatever you want to call it, it should be a case where you can control your weight a couple of kilos, be able to pull it in a little bit if you know maybe you've gotten a little bit too YOLO, but actually get educated on how to do that. Because if you don't have any confidence and understanding of what's in food, it's going to be very, 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 very difficult to get to that point where you can be so intuitive with eating. And intuitive eating is something that I get asked about a lot, same with intermittent fasting, so I'll probably have to do a couple of podcasts on these. They're very different things, but intuitive eating, guys, is at the end of the day basically you are leaving it down to your intuition on what you should put in your gob. Now, does that work for 90% of the population? Definitely not, in my opinion. Why? Because 90% of the population probably don't know what they should be putting in their mouth. 10% of the population, maybe less, maybe 5, maybe 2, people who are highly educated on nutrition, training, have a very good relationship with food, have very good connection with their emotions and feelings. So they're not binge eaters, not mindless eaters. They see food as fuel. They know when to stop when they're full, not when they're stuffed. These are the people that could do intuitive eating and do it really well. The other people, I think, are going to struggle. Now, if you're someone that doesn't have a good relationship with food, let's say, for example, you have no idea about nutrition, you don't know what to eat, you get takeaways a lot, you maybe don't eat breakfast, you eat like 2 meals a day and it's McDonald's and maybe a sandwich at lunch. Now, do you think if someone like that, who say overweight, consuming McDonald's and a sandwich and that's the daily intake and maybe a couple of beers on the weekend, do you think if they intuitively ate that they would get leaner? Probably not, because they're probably going to intuitively eat the exact same way that they're eating now. But say, for example, you've had a client and they've been, or a person that's been tracking their macros, being accountable for maybe 6 months, a year even. And then if they go intuitively eat, they've already built up good habits. So they're going to carry those habits over. If they've already been consuming protein every couple of hours throughout the day, having 4 or 5 good nutrient dense meals a day, do you think they're then going to go intuitively eat 2 meals a day, one being McDonald's and one being a sandwich? Probably not. They're probably going to intuitively eat similar types of foods, listen to their hunger signs, know when to eat, know about their digestive system, know about so many things so that they're getting more confident with their food choices in an intuitive fashion. So my big thing with clients is if you've never tracked before, you've never done anything before, you've never got educated on nutrition, intuitive eating is going to be tough. So make sure that you get educated first, and that might take a really tough period of 6 to 12 months working with a coach, working on a program, whatever, that educates you on that type of system. And that's going to be hard. And a lot of people won't want to do that. A lot of people don't want to spend their time getting educated. A lot of people just want results. And this is where it comes back to what I was talking about before and setting the standard for your life. If you want the standard for your life to be constantly yo-yoing on and off diets, to be constantly being confused when it comes to nutrition and training, if you want to be constantly stressed about what you're doing when it comes to your fitness goals, then keep doing those yo-yo diets. But if you want to make a change and actually get educated and actually change your life so that nutrition and training is easy, it's not even a big stress for you. It's just something you do daily and you understand it and you know what to put in your gob. You know how to make smart choices. Then investing 6 or 12 months into some form of education is probably going to be the best thing for you. that's going to set the standard for your new life. So it might be almost taking a few baby steps back or slowing things down in order for you to progress forward, but then you're probably never ever going to have to do that again. So guys, at the end of the day, like, you don't just become someone overnight. You don't just, you know, become a leader overnight. You don't just become a shredded fitness model overnight. You don't just become some champion powerlifter overnight. You don't become like a Michael Jordan overnight. These sort of expectations versus realities don't happen overnight. And I think that that's a big thing that society today, like, things have become too easy. Things have become too accessible. And social media paints things out to be a lot easier than what they are. And what I mean by this is that if you want something bad enough, you'll put in the work. But if you just want the result and you don't really enjoy the journey, you don't really know why you're doing the journey, you just want to look a certain way, or you just want to have something in your life, you're probably not going to follow through on it. So at the end of the day, you want to set the standard for your life that everything you're doing every single day when you wake up, every single moment of your day, you're focusing on moving more towards the story that you want to have in your life, creating a life that you want to live. And where nutrition and training fits into that, that's just a part of it. Because we know that, you know, if you focus on working on your physique, your nutrition, your mindset, all of these things, you're not only going to feel better about yourself, but you're going to be more confident. So I'm not saying that aesthetics is everything. It is absolutely not. I've been shredded. I've been a little bit more overweight. I've been very, very skinny and unhealthy, all of these cycles. And I can tell you that probably the happiest I've ever been is probably right now, and probably the last 6 to 12 months, where I actually hit the heaviest I've ever been in my life last year. And did that bother me? Yeah, of course. I'll be transparent with you guys. I remember seeing it and being a little bit shocked. But the funny thing was, if that had been a few years ago, I would have gone into this like spiral of self-pity and hated myself. Whereas now I was like, oh shit, probably need to like tidy it up a little bit, start tracking again. Hadn't tracked macros for a while, was intuitively eating for like 6-12 months, and I just laughed at it. I was like, shit son, time to rein it in. No more going out for free meals 4 or 5 times a week. So at the end of the day, your attitude changes, your perspective changes, because I just looked at it and I was like, okay, that's funny, but I probably should do something about it and get a little bit more strict and get a little bit more accountable again, because that's what I encourage my clients to do, and I need to be a role model at the end of the day. But that doesn't mean that I need to track every single day of my life. I don't encourage my clients to do that either. There needs to be some form of a balance, but then also progression in what you're doing. So at the end of the day, setting standards for your life, that's what we're chatting about today. So there's a fine line, in my opinion, between going too intensely and too all out and burning yourself out, trying to be a perfectionist and trying to do everything perfectly, trying to get somewhere really fast, not being patient with the results. And like I said before, that does end up burning you out completely. I've been there. And there's that balance between that and just sheer laziness. And there is a lot of people who say they want results, say they want to be shredded, say they want to be this, say they want to be that. But guys, they just don't have the testicles for it. They're just lazy. Like, and you can out-train laziness in a few ways, but at the same time, your goals have to be mean so, so much to you that you want to move away from laziness and move into a better position. The biggest way that you can remove laziness or reduce the amount of laziness you have when it comes to being around your goals is make sure your goals are clear, specific, and that you set up habits every single day that help you get closer to them. Because if you make your goals really difficult and none of your daily habits move you closer to that goal, it's going to be harder. So what I always say to my clients is we want to move away from the ability to fail. Or we want to reduce the amount of failures that happen in our day, because failure is going to happen. That's going to happen. But the more you can reduce it, the more progress you're going to make, one. But then you're also not going to feel like a complete fucking failure all the time. A little bit of failure is okay because it's going to help you grow. But what I basically mean by this is, let's say, for example, you have really bad daily habits. So let's say, for example, you wake up in the morning and the first thing you do is go on social media. Then the second thing you do is get coffee. And then the third thing you do is, what's another one? And go on Facebook. So you went Instagram, coffee, Facebook, and then you go straight to work. Now, if your goal at this point is to reduce stress in your life, and say improve your body composition, And the first thing you're doing is filling your brain with social media of somebody else, of another perfect physique that you're looking at and going, why don't I look like that? Does that put you in a positive headspace for the day? Probably not. Then the second thing you're doing is having coffee. So before you've even let your brain stimulate for a minute, you've already gone on social media, you've already had caffeine and you're trying to reduce your stress levels, and then you've gone back on social media and gone straight to work. So you haven't really done anything for your day that gets you closer to your goal of being a more confident person, less stressed person, and having more happiness in your life. So what I mean by setting yourself up success, not failure, would be creating a morning routine that improves this. So for example, that might be as simple as first thing you do when you wake up in the morning is you write in a grateful journal, something that you're grateful for that day, something you're going to achieve that day, or it might be just simply going for a walk, going for a quick walk around the block, going for a walk with your pet, dog, cat, whatever. It might be something as simple as that, getting up, doing some morning stretching, getting in the zone, focusing on what you're going to achieve today, how you're going to be productive, how you're going to kick today's ass, not waking up and going, why don't I have a big booty and a small waist? Because that is not going to get you in the right mindset for the day. And the second thing might be, I'm going to consume, you know, a couple of hundred mils of water first thing in the morning after I do my morning gratitude, or before, whichever order, doesn't matter, it's up to you. Then the next thing, I'm going to prepare a healthy breakfast, whether or not you have that breakfast then and there, whether you make a smoothie that you're taking in the car and you drive to work, but you're going to prepare something that you can consume. Then you can have a coffee if you want. But do you see what I mean, guys? You want to set up strategies and habits that you do every single day that get you closer to your goals. And that's setting a standard for your life. So if you're someone guilty of this, that is always running around like a headless chook, this used to be me, I would be late to everything. I would be disorganized. I would be stressed. I would be frazzled. First thing I would do in the morning would be get on my emails. So already busy enough. And then I'd be like, oh, well, I'll sleep for 6 hours. And then as soon as I wake up, I'll start work again at 5 a.m. And that didn't set up a good standard for my life, because whenever I woke up, I would go to bed working and I would wake up working. And what ended up happening is I got really, really burnt out. I started hating my job. I started hating what I did. I didn't want to go to the gym myself because I felt like I was always working and my work was the fitness industry. So then I changed my morning routine. No matter what, first thing in the morning, even if I have millions of emails to get back to, heaps of work to get back to, I'm allowed and I allow myself to have at least half an hour for myself to get in a good state. And that good state would be things like I said before. It would be making sure that I'm nourishing myself, doing something for my mindset, doing something to move my body, and then getting in a good state for the day. The other one for me is writing down tasks and to-do lists for the day. So making sure that I'm organized in that setting so I don't get too stressed out. I don't try to tick off everything in one day, and to set that standard for myself. Ever since I've done those simple things, I've been able to progress so, so much quicker in terms of productivity, in terms of stress levels, in terms of even my clients have been happier because I've been getting back to them more quickly, better responses, been more productive. Because what I was finding is when I was doing those crazy hours, working till midnight, getting up at 6, working, blah, 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 I wasn't actually that efficient because I was so tired, so stressed, not enjoying it. When you enjoy your work, it's completely different. So having that bit of 30 minutes to get in a good state, be excited about your work to start, has really, really changed my day. And that's the same in the evening, having some kind of evening or morning routine. So when it comes to standards for your life, you can decide how you want to set them. So I won't make this podcast too long today. Got some work to get back to. But you make a choice of the standard of your life you want to live. And if the standard of your life, you're okay with that being maybe a little bit of a lazy slob, or maybe, you know, whatever, going and binge drinking out on the weekends, having cheat meals and then trying to be, you know, get back on track on a Monday, that's cool, no judgment. But you get to choose the standard for which you want to set your life. So if you want to stay in the current physique you're in and you're okay with that, that's cool. But if you actually physically want to change your physique, change your body, change your mindset, whatever it is, you have to work on it. You can't just expect it to happen. So you've got to up your standard that you want to live. You've got to up the expectations. Don't ever let anyone tell you you can't do something, because that shits me up the wall. I get it all the time. I get my clients come to me and I've told them that we're going to work on something, work towards a goal. This is the plan. This is the strategy. We're going to get it done. And they'll have hate from their friends, loved ones, partner, whatever, saying, oh, you're on another diet again. Oh, you're on another this again. And they take it really, really personally. And I have to almost talk them off the ledge and be like, why are you doing this? You're trying to up the standard for your life. And if they don't see that right now, and they're okay with the standard that they're living in, and they're okay with the standard that you're living in, but you're not okay with it, you want to be better, you want to do better, you want more for your life, then that's cool. You don't have to explain it to them, but you need to be confident in what you're doing. So increasing the standard for your life and making sure that you set that bar where you want it to be if you want to achieve more. So for me personally, there's so many things I still want to achieve, but then I'm also proud of things that I've been able to tick off over the last 6 to 12 months that I never thought I'd be capable of until I raised that standard of my life that I wanted. So there's nothing wrong with setting the bar high, but with that, remember, we want to make sure we're not aiming for perfectionism. So even though you're setting goals, setting targets, setting all these things, make sure that the path to get there is flexible and that you're not too rigid on the time frame is a big one. Because there's going to be bumps in the road, there's going to be failures, there's going to be challenges. But as long as you keep focusing on that higher standard for your life, you're going to keep progressing forward. So I want you guys to email me. I want you guys to email me. Remember, like I said, email me. Tell me what's going on. Tell me if you enjoyed this podcast. And tell me what standard for your life do you want to live. I'd be really interested in your stories, because then I can create more content around that. I can create another podcast on it. I'd love to hear what standard you want to live. So for me, in my life, the standard that I want to have for my life is I want to always have a healthy mind-body connection. I always want to be internally healthy, and I'm going to always uphold that. No matter how old I am, I'm always going to go to the gym. I'm always going to eat nourishing foods for 80, 90% of the time, but I'm not going to be so strict. I'm going to have a flexible life. This is going to be the standard for my life, a flexible life with clear goals and expectations, but also good quality standards without perfectionism. The other standards for my life I want is freedom. I want flexibility with my work. I want to be happy with the job that I do every single day when I wake up. That is a big standard that I live by now. And since I've lived by that standard, I've been so happy with my clients, with everything, because I think that you just attract the energy that you put out. And I've been so blessed to have some of the best clients, honestly, ever. Like, I love all of my clients right now, and I can say that with utter happiness. There is not one client that I'm like, oh, like, don't know if this is going to work. I don't know if this is going to happen. Like, I literally get excited to open their emails. Like, that is how you want your life to be, to get excited to go in a Facebook group and see what they're all up to. Like, that is pretty cool. So the other standard for my life is that I won't surround myself with negative people. I'll surround myself with people that are going to contribute to my life in a positive fashion and that I can contribute to theirs. So that's another standard. So that might be the case of removing certain people from your life, toxic people, this and that. So that was one that I promised myself at the start of this year. Another standard for my life is that I won't put expectations on myself that are unachievable. I'll be realistic, but I'll also push myself, and I'll push myself to do more, be more, act more, wherever I can and whenever I can, if I have that ability. And the other standard for my life is to make sure that I'm helping people, make sure that I have the ability to give to others and give back in society. And these are just a few of the standards. So I want you guys to think about the standard for your life and maybe even write down a list or a code that you want to live by. And that's going to be something that you can reflect back on all the time. So I'm going to leave you at that for the day. I know it was a little bit of a lifestyle chit chat, but I've been really enjoying these. So if you've been enjoying these too, please email me. My direct email is alice@aliceround.com. If you do want to have any inquiries in terms of coaching, anything like that, then it's info@aliceround.com. And yeah, if you want, we will probably be running a mindset seminar, not sure on the 100% topic yet. And probably also doing another binge eating one coming up soon. So if you would love to come to any camps or seminars that we'll be running, please email me as well, any topics that you love covered, because at the end of the day, I do these podcasts for you guys to have this content, to listen to me rambling. And really that's it, so that we can connect as well. So please, if you're enjoying the podcast, share them, tag friends, tag mates, whatever, let's get them out there. And I really, really hope that this has motivated you to set some new standards for your life. And I'll chat to you soon. See you, legends. Thank you for listening to another episode of Breakthrough the Bullshit. If you enjoyed this podcast, I would love it if you could leave a review on iTunes. Let me know, comment what you'd love to see more of, and be sure you've also subscribed on YouTube and iTunes for updates. And if you'd like more info, then you can also add the Team Round Support Facebook page,
which is available to access for all of you, and you just simply need to search for it on Facebook.